So question four, can intelligent design be a part of the construct of science? One thing in there I'd like to say is, you know, when I was a Christian, I tried to be a young earth creationist, but I couldn't really do it. It was just asking me too much to believe that I couldn't believe it. So then I was kind of an old earth creationist like you are. And then I accepted evolution. And I became an evolutionary creationist and kind of went through a little bit of ID in there too, intelligent design. But I just want to bring up this topic. There's two kinds of intelligent design out there. One is this is what the evolutionary creationists say. There's a traditional kind of intelligent design which they like, and that's basically based on the Bible, Psalms 19:1, for example. It says, "The heavens declare the glory of God; the skies proclaim the work of His hands." And they accept evolution, so they would say that's God's majesty and everything shows His wonderful working and all that. But the Discovery Institute is promoting a thing called intelligent design. And that is the kind of intelligent design I think you're talking about. And you would like to see that kind of intelligent design be a construct of science. Is that right?
Well, you know, my focus isn't necessarily to try to reform the nature of science. You know, my focus is basically to show people that scientific discoveries harmonize with a biblical view of the world. That's really my focus. But, you know, I do think that, you know, apart from, you know, what my agenda is, so to speak, I do think that you could incorporate intelligent design into the construct of science. For example, in effect, we already are doing that. When you look at something like SETI, the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, I mean, that whole enterprise is predicated on the ability to distinguish basically signals emanating from some kind of star system to distinguish signals that would arise through natural mechanism versus signals that would arise from intelligent agency. And so there's an instance where we are incorporating intelligent design into the enterprise of science. So the question would be, why couldn't you extend that idea and just say, hey, when it comes to the origin of life, you know, let's say, you know, why couldn't we take the results from, let's say, synthetic biology and say, you know, is this, is it, you know, reasonable to posit the idea that life emanates from the work of a mind? And if so, you know, how would we make that, how would we distinguish that, or how would we identify
and by
that?
The work, so, you know, there's that famous cartoon where there's two scientists and they have this equation, and then it says right in the middle, then a miracle happens, and then it carries on, and they says, I think you should be a little bit more specific in this step. You know that cartoon?
Yeah.
It's a pretty famous cartoon. I mean, isn't that exactly what ID is trying to say, is that basically you need God to do a miracle? Like, for example, you don't believe in evolution. You think whales just popped into existence from nothing, and humans just popped into existence from nothing. So it's just like in your when you explain how things happen, it's just like then a miracle happens, right?
Yeah. Well, I would say that you are positing that a miracle happened, but it doesn't necessarily mean that the laws of nature were necessarily violated in that process. I mean, God could have created outside the laws of nature or within the laws of nature. So, I mean, you've got those options available to you if you embrace design. But I think the idea would be that there's a direct intervention in some capacity where the intelligent agency is exerting, you know, His will, you know, on the created order in such a way to affect some kind of an outcome. So I guess you could call that a miracle. But it doesn't necessarily mean that you can't probe.
Do you have a problem with God violating laws of nature? Because I thought you just said that it wouldn't violate the laws of nature.
Well, I mean, there could be miracles in which God isn't violating the laws of nature. There could be, you know, miracles where God is doing something outside the laws of nature, you know, or God could work within the laws of nature. Both could be viewed as being miraculous events. Where, you know, God, again, is working within the laws of nature, outside the laws of nature.
Well, let me bring up one obvious. We only got like 2 minutes here. I just wanted to bring up this one thing here. One problem with the intelligent design community is that they don't really seem to have a very coherent position. Because, for example, Michael Behe's one of the fathers of this movement, and yet he says he believes that humans descended from other apes, from other animals, and some of them don't accept that. So some of them accept human evolution and some of them don't. So, you know, isn't there a consistency problem with what even the platform is trying to teach or proclaim?
Well, you know, I wouldn't disagree with what you're saying, because, you know, one of the friendly criticisms that we've leveled against intelligent design at Reasons to Believe, and I would consider myself to be an ID person, but one of the criticisms we've leveled at it is that there's not a model that they have. So when you embrace intelligent design, kind of the Discovery Institute variety, are you embracing young Earth creationism or old Earth creationism? Are you embracing common descent or limited common descent or no common descent at all? You know, and so it's there's not really a clear model or even a clear collection of models that are being advanced. And so, you know, I think that criticism that you're leveling is about incoherence is a valid criticism.
So you make it sound, in your viewpoint, there's maybe different, do you guys have like a different form of intelligent design then? Because in my mind, I was just thinking intelligent design was just promoted by the Discovery Institute. Is there another proponent of it, or unofficial?
I would say that, I would say that I'm an intelligent design proponent in the sense that I think there's evidence for design in the construct of the universe. I think biochemical systems are designed as well, you know, and even biological systems. Mm-hmm. But, you know, that we take this concept of intelligent design and we anchor it within a particular, you know, model that we would call old Earth creationism, you know, and then within that we make some very specific, you know, statements as to how we think things transpired in the history of life on Earth.
Okay.
So we're trying, you know, in other words, a lot of what the Discovery Institute is focused on is really design detection, you know, versus, you know, and of course I think design detection is, you know, something that you would need to do to advance the intelligent design position. But just because you can detect design doesn't mean you've got any kind of model.
Okay.
So to me, it's unsatisfying for the reason that you're complaining about it being incoherent, because a model then would take that idea that you can detect design and then place it within a framework that attempts to have explanatory power about, mm-hmm. you know, the origin of life and the history of life, let's say.
Right. Yes. Yeah, they need to have some explanatory power, some predictions and all that. Okay, so the next question.